but she defied the doctors. Plus, he was born severely disabled, but he became an athletic champion. He is a star on the court and off. Winners against all odds. It's all next on Larry King Live. Welcome back, everybody. I'm Nancy Grace from Court TV and Headline News in for Larry tonight. Thank you for being with us. Tonight, inspiring stories of people who won against all odds. Let me introduce them to you. From LA, Angela Rockwood Gwynn, actress and model. She was left a quadriplegic just weeks before her wedding date. Isn't she full? I'll tell you her story in just a moment. Joining me from Sacramento, Roger Crawford. Roger was born with a rare genetic defect, and he has gone on to become a star, both an athlete and a motivational speaker and author. Incredible. In LA, Carlana Stone Lawson. She was a high school cheerleader and class president. A traffic crash left her without the use of her legs. As inspired as you may be by Angela, we've got another story for you. Roger is with us. Roger Crawford. With his disability, he turned into a star athlete and now is an author and motivational speaker. I can't wait for you to hear his story. Please stay with us.
Hi, I'm Roger Crawford. You just spent a few moments watching me play tennis, and you're probably as to how I was holding on to the tennis racket. Well, I slipped my right finger in between the space that you see in the tennis racket. Then I hold the grip to my right elbow with my left hand. Now, I neglected to tell you that I had the best two-handed serve in the world. Well, I had the only two-handed serve in the world. Even though I wear a prosthesis on my left leg, you probably noticed that I had fairly good mobility on the tennis court.
Welcome back. I'm Nancy Grace from Court TV and Headline News. And for Larry tonight, thank you for being with us. I want to go straight back out to a story everyone said, no way, and he said, way. Joining me, Roger Crawford out of Sacramento. Now, Roger has a so-called disability. It's called ectrodactylism. What is that?
Well, Nancy, it affects me from the elbows down and from the knees down. Doctors really don't know. It was just something random that happened. I have bodied parents and also an able-bodied daughter. So they really don't know what happened.
Now, tell me, Roger, how did your parents treat you as you were growing up?
You know, Nancy, I remember my father saying to me, Roger, we don't live in Pity City. He used to say, take your hands out of your pockets, put a smile on your face, be proud of who you are. I remember he used to tell me whenever I had my hands in my pockets, he says, you know, you're never going to reach higher with your hands in your pockets. So I guess to answer your question, they never let me feel sorry for myself or, you know, asking them, you know, am I gifted? And my dad used to say, don't ask, am I gifted? Ask, how are you gifted? You know, I'm a lousy piano player. I had to accept that as a young age, but it allowed me to focus in on the possibilities in my life instead of the problems.
Roger, I'm sorry, I was reading. What did you say? Oh, it's a book by you. How High Can You Bounce? Turn Your Setbacks into Comebacks.
Thank you.
Incredible. And not only that, I've got From the Heart, also by Roger Crawford. I'm totally knocked out. Now, tell me, what inspired you to become a star athlete? In fact, you sent another star athlete home packing when he didn't make the tennis team, right?
Well, Nancy, I played tennis at Loyola Marymount University in Los Angeles, and I learned that I wasn't going to be the fastest or the most powerful, but if I could hit the ball over the net one more time than my opponent, then I'd win the point. It's funny, I was watching the video a little earlier, and I think I should tell you that the video is edited. You notice I didn't miss a shot the entire match.
Hey, Roger, question. Remember when you asked your dad to write a note to your teachers asking for an extension on a handwritten assignment?
Right. I sure do. I remember my dad said to me, you know what, Roger? You have to do the best you can with what you have. They never let me feel sorry for myself.
Like growing up with your disability?
Well, Nancy, certainly there were times that I was discouraged and times that I felt left out. But, you know, I grew up with the belief that everybody has challenges, Nancy. You know, some you can see and some you can't. You know, I'm so inspired by the other guests you have tonight, and I think all of their stories really reaffirm my belief that a broken spirit is a lot more disabling than a broken body.
Roger, you became a competitive tennis player in college and then actually went pro. That's a dream millions of people have all across the world.
Right. Well, you know, Nancy, people ask me all the time, Roger, if you were able-bodied, you probably would have been a Wimbledon champion or played in the U.S. Open, and I'm really not so sure. You know, I had to learn to do the best I could with what I had. And I think that's true for all of us and all of our life experiences. You know, I recently had the opportunity of speaking at Walter Reed to injured soldiers returning from Iraq and Afghanistan, one of my greatest honors. I met this young man. He had lost both his arms at the elbow. I'll never forget him. He had this infectious smile. And I walked up to him and I said, I'm so amazed by your attitude. And he said something that I'll never forget. He looked down at his arms and he said, I'm just wondering what God's gonna do with this. And I thought, wow, that's somebody who sees the possibilities in his life.
Roger, that person that told you you could have been a champion was all wrong. You are a champion, friend.
Thank you, Nancy. Thank you so much.
His books, How High Can You Bounce? And Playing from the Heart, incredible. I know one thing, I'm not gonna wake up and complain in the morning. Stay with us.